Hello, today we're going to talk about angle-angle similarity, and this is specifically for triangles, all right? So the theorem says if two angles of one triangle are congruent to two angles of another triangle, why don't we just show what that looks like really quick before we even finish that sentence. So I want you to draw a triangle that's kind of smallish over here. And then try to draw that exact same triangle, except make it a bit bigger. So what I mean by exactly the same, I mean the proportions look the same. So it looks like we just sort of zoomed out a bit, well actually in a bit, right, to make it look closer. We'll call this one ABC. And the second triangle is DEF. Okay, so it says if two angles of one triangle are congruent to two angles of another triangle. So let's just illustrate that with A being congruent to D, and then B being congruent to E. It says then the two triangles are similar. So I think one of the key things here is because this is a triangle and the angles always add up to 180 degrees, we know that these last two angles have to be the same. So if two of them are the same, that means the third one also has to be the same. But because we can already assume that, you only have to know that you have two angles the same. And then however it looks, it's going to look the same. It's just going to look a little bigger or a little smaller, depending on the side lengths. So let's write this in notation over here. So if angle A is congruent to angle D, and angle B is congruent to angle E, then triangle ABC, whoops, started to write the wrong letter there, is similar to triangle DEF. So notice this symbol here means similar to. Just kind of a nice short way of writing that. I just realized my arrow makes it look a little funny. All right, so let's test this out. It says, are these triangles similar? Looks like we've got a right angle. So we've got one angle that's the same. And then because these two aren't the same, however, we could find angle E very easily, right? We could say, well, if we already have a right angle, the other two have to add up to 90. So we've got 90 minus 26. And it looks like this one's also 64 degrees. And what I mean by also, it matches this one here. So we don't even have to look at the third one because we already have a right angle that's the same. 64 degrees are the same. So now we can say triangle. Now when you write a similarity statement, you do have to match up the angles that match. It doesn't matter what you write for the first one. So we could just say triangle DEC. It totally doesn't matter what order you write that in. However, in the second one, you do have to line it up and say, okay, which angle is the same as D in the other triangle? Looks like G. So put G first, and then E is 64, which matches with H, and then C is 26, which matches with K, because we didn't write it in, but that one's also 26. That's very, very important to keep those in the right order. Okay, show that the two triangles are similar. This time it's sort of like a proof, but we're not doing this in a very formal way. We're just going to kind of explain why they're similar. Okay, so we could say that angle A is congruent to angle A. You might say, well, of course, that's because of the reflexive property. So reflexive is the one where the same angle is the same as the same angle, right? Okay, and then we could say angle B is congruent to angle C. And we know that just because it's given to us. We see that they're both 52 degrees, so we could say that's given. And then because we already have two angles, they're the same, we can already say that triangle ABE, once again, the first one doesn't matter. So ABE, we're highlighting this small triangle here. So A matches up with angle A in the other triangle, B matches up with C, and then E matches up with D. That would be how you write the similarity statement. All right, let's look at this problem here. Okay, so you can use similar triangles to find measurements indirectly. So let's see how we do this. It says here, a flagpole casts a shadow that's 50 feet long. At the same time, a woman standing nearby, who is 5 feet 4 inches tall, casts a shadow that's 40 inches long. How tall is the flagpole to the nearest foot? Okay, so we do have a little picture, but sometimes it's more useful to have this defined out a little more clearly. So let's draw a quick little diagram. This one's going to be the person. It says the person has a 40-inch long shadow, and then they are 64 inches tall. Oh, actually, we don't know that yet. So we could set up... So 5 feet 4 inches just seems like it's more simple to write in inches. We could do feet also and do a decimal, but I think we're going to go ahead and use this in inches. So we're going to say 64 inches. Well, actually, we also want to match it up with this. That means they can be the same in the other one. So we've got 40 inches matched up with, just remember there's 12 inches in a foot. So 5 times 12 is 60. And then we have the extra 4 inches to add on there. And so that's why the person is 64 inches. So 64 inches. And let's draw our other triangle. There's sort of a default thing. We're assuming that there's a 90 degree angle here and a 90 degree angle right here. And so now we have the flagpole casts a shadow that's 50 feet long. And now since we used inches in both of our units for the last triangle, we actually don't have to use inches for this one, but we do want to use the same units for both of them. So it means that our x is going to be in feet, which is actually what we want. X is our unknown, so we're just going to set it up like that. Okay, and you might say, well, how do we know these triangles are similar? So this is assuming that the sun that's up here, because it's so high, it's going to cause the same angle to happen right here, and the same angle to happen right here. So we have two angles that are the same, which means we know these are similar. So now we can set up a proportion. I usually just put the one that I don't know on top. And that one compares to 64, the same way that 50. So make sure that you start with the same triangle. So we started with this triangle on top last time, which means we need to start with that triangle on the second one as well. So 50 over 40. And then once you set it up, it's really quick to solve a proportion. So we did review this recently, but one more time. Think about it as you multiply diagonally. So you get 40x equals, and think about it, these two being diagonal from each other, 50 times 64. And then when you multiply that, you get 40x equals 3,200. And then we're going to divide both sides by 40 to get that x all by itself, because that's the unknown. And when you divide that, you get 80 feet. All right, that's it.